Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot, and welcome back to Black Rock Park, our franchise build for Planet Zoo. In today's video, we're going to finish off the timber, or very nearly finish off the Timberwolf habitat that we started in the previous episode. Now, you'll see, first of all, I finished the tracks. About half of the comments on the last video were about the railway tracks. Someone, I can't remember who, actually left a very helpful photo, which I used as a reference, and I think the tracks look like they're meant to now. Anyways, today is going to be a very, very, and I know this sounds a little odd coming from me of all people, it's going to be a very foliage-heavy episode. Basically, all we're doing for the next 2 hours or so is putting down foliage, because the creek itself, or whatever you want to call it, this little river area, is kind of already built. You know, the foundation's there, the water's there, the mine, you know, skirting around the border is already there. So everything is done except making this creek come alive. So that means a lot of foliage. It means a hell of a lot of foliage. It's about 2 hours worth of footage, and I'd say other than, you know, putting the fences in here at the start and dabbling around a little bit to make sure the wolves can't escape, I'd say about an hour and 55 of it or something like that is literally me putting down foliage. So it took a very, very, very long time. I did learn quite a lot about, I think, making foliage look more natural across the whole journey kind of thing. I think the whole thing comes together really, really well. It looked really beautiful. It is dangerously close to a My Pen Rye style exhibit, and that's very much something I want to avoid. So, you know, this will be the only time we do something like this. I'm going to try to go back in that slightly more modern direction next time. This is kind of the capper to the, you know, we've got this whole traditional section over here next to the Grizzly Bear Lake, next to the little museum with the planetarium, stuff like that. So this is like the capper, the piece de resistance for the for this area, for the traditional area of the park. And the idea is after this we'll go back to a slightly more modern approach. But I had a lot of fun with this. It was, like I say, nearly 2 hours of just putting down foliage. And for those who know me, know that that's gonna work for me. That's definitely my kind of thing. So just making sure the wolves can't escape initially. There's some fairly horrible looking little land there. Bring that bit up there as well, and there you go. Really easy to do. The wolves cannot escape already. Everything, yeah, so there's going to be a lot of foliage for putting down a lot of dirt and stuff. The wolves, I will say, aren't totally happy with the environment. There's more long grass than they would like. They'd like a lot more dirt or a lot more rock or even a little bit more short grass. But I felt it was more important to get across this kind of lush, verdant, natural-looking creek more so than it was to get across the to precisely match the wolves' requirements. They're still very happy, but they're not 100%, basically. People did tell me you can actually do something pretty cool with the water. If you put a glass barrier around the front, it will actually work as well. My problem is, I think for that to function, I did try it, but it wasn't deep enough. The water wasn't deep enough, and I think you have to have quite a deep river for that to happen. And for me to get the feeling that I wanted for this creek, I have to keep the water fairly shallow. So I am going to use the land at the start, and then we're going to do like a little rocky waterfall, and we're going to do like a log, and you'll see. So I'm only going to use about four types of tree. I think actually four types of tree in this entire thing. I kind of had a little feeling in mind, like I want the right hand side to be this very lush forest with lots of, you know, these spruce trees on the right hand side, keeping it, you know, fairly varied in terms of the height and stuff like that. And then the left hand side towards the mine, where there's more rock, there's more dirt, where the land has been ruined somewhat by the mine and the mountain, is going to be more these sort of tall, less leafy trees, because they don't have the sustenance to grow such leaves. So it makes more sense to me that the left would be slightly more bare and the right would be these very, you know, spruce to me screams grizzly bear and timber wolf for some reason. It just does. That just looks like somewhere a wolf would live. So we're going to put quite a lot of these on the right. It's meant to in part feel like this big, again, like a big impenetrable forest that kind of goes on for way further behind the exhibit. Even though it, in reality, it, you know, doesn't. It actually might, because I don't think we can put anything behind there exhibit-wise, but we'll talk about that kind of stuff in the non-time-lapse portion of the video. So already I think that looks way better. Just bringing the trees in did a lot. Did so much for making this feel like I wanted it to feel, but we have not even got started on the foliage. We really haven't. I've come up with some new techniques and ideas and stuff like that that you're going to see implemented throughout this video, but it's a lot of foliage. It's a lot of rocks as well. I think we're going to be doing the rocks in a minute. I think that's probably about all the trees that I want. Doing some at the back just to give it a little bit of variety. A couple of these, I think they're beech trees. I can't tell, I'm too fast, too speedy. This is on, I believe, 6.7 times speed for reference as well. That looks nice though, looks better already. We're going to bring in a lot of these rose bushes. I try to keep the foliage usage fairly consistent across the entire thing. You know, we're going to see a lot of rose bushes. We're going to see a lot of, again, the... can't remember what it's called. The little white plant. What's that cheeky little devil called? We're going to see a lot of that. We're going to see a lot of reeds. Every now and again, you might get a little bit of twin flower and stuff like that. But by and large, I'm trying to keep the foliage fairly uniform. I quite like this idea. We're hiding the land behind the log. Basically, the log's fallen across. Maybe the rushing water in this area, you know, contributed to it. It made the tree fall over, essentially, you know, wore down the tree until the point where it collapsed over the edge of the waterfall. Is it log time? Nope, nope. Putting some food in there so they don't die. It was getting dark and spooky, so we're kind of going to speed up time now, get our research done, some basic stuff like that. I wanted to get back to midday precisely, because that's basically the best time to build because of the lack of shadows. There you go, a nice little view of it in the mist. Looks pretty nice. Needs foliage. not sure what we're going to do next. I actually haven't really thought about it. Next video, of course, we're going to do our big cleanup episode. We're going to add loads of new stuff all around the park. We're going to finish the planetarium. Just doing a little rock bridge thingamajiggy here, just because I want the park staff to be able to cross over from one part to another in order to, so I can move the food somewhere a little bit more, you know, just better looking, essentially. There's going to be a lot of rocks. I like the idea. We've got this little rocky waterfall overhang here. The water's going to fairly natural when I rejig it a little bit later on. It's going to kind of like move through the rocks and kind of tumble out to the other side. It ends up looking pretty cool. But by and large, I wouldn't say there's that much to say about the amount of rocks we're about to place. There's a whole bunch of temperate rocks. Temperate rocks for blimmin' days. I do apologize, by the way, if you hear someone having a rave outside my bedroom door, it's because somebody's having a rave outside my bedroom door. I don't quite know what's going on, but I've heard the music and I've heard the singing. I imagine there's a night out going on, but yeah. If it gets loud, I apologize. If it gets loud, we'll join in. We'll just, you know, we'll pop a little rave ourselves. Sounds fun, right? Not been a rave in ages. Anyways, so, what was I saying? No idea. Actually, don't remember. Rocks and trees and plants, they all go together so well. Every rock needs little plants poking out from it. Every tree needs a little bit of foliage around the base. Every bush needs to be sunk a little bit into the ground. I really like the North American set that we're using. We're using the exact same foliage we've used in the rest of the park, so that's tundra, taiga, and it's not grassland, what is it? Bloody can't remember. Temperate! It's right there, it says right there. Temperate. We're just using those three, so the foliage is consistent with basically the entirety of the rest of the park. A lot of nettles, a lot of twin flowers, a lot of temperate rock, blah 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 blah. This is a hard one to narrate, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it's just foliage. There's some stuff later on I can think about, but for now I'm just sticking trees in. A lot of times you'll see me shift back towards the start of the exhibit and kind of turn the camera around. I feel like that is kind of my main viewpoint for making this thing look good. You'll see, you just saw it then, I just shifted back in there again. Shifting back over here to see what needs adding. You know, do we need trees anywhere? Do we need more stuff anywhere to bring the whole thing to life a little bit more? By and large, I mean, I think you could get away with this as an exhibit. It looks perfectly nice, you know. But it's this that makes the exhibits come to life. I actually think this is a thing the game needs. The game needs like various grass options, because I'm using bushes as grass. What we're going to do by the end of this, and bearing in mind there's half of this time lapse left, is put down so much bush into the ground. Just bush for absolute days, ladies and gentlemen. Bush for absolute days. I'm going to put so much of it into the ground that it basically looks like the grass texture. If you go and look, I mean, I was looking at pictures of creeks for references and stuff like that, but if you just go and look in the wilderness, in the forests and stuff like that, the grass isn't like this. It isn't just this flat plain with some leaves of grass. If you're going to do like a field, then the grass looks great, but if you want it to look like a, you know, like a lush forest kind of thing, you need to cover the ground in stuff, absolutely cover it, and we will by the end. We will utterly cover it. chucking a little bit of moss on the rocks. Carpet moss is quite hard to work with without it looking a little bit daft, but yeah, it's just little details. I kind of want to change that the more that I look at it now. Some grilled rose bushes, which are beautiful. What are these called again? Labrador tea, that's it. That's my, possibly the main choice of flower for the entire park, actually. There's something about it. That kind of stark whiteness kind of goes pretty well with both the rose bushes, as you can see, but also with the, with like the modern angle that the park has taken, you know? That lack of colour is seen as quite a modern, minimalist sort of shebang, I guess. So there's quite a few of those in. I do try to put them in relatively the same position. Here we've got this big, lush... I'm going to stop saying lush. I hate the word. I don't know why I keep using it. But lots of rose bushes, lots of rocks, all sort of jumbled together into this big, overgrown mess, which we'll work on a little bit later. Not going to go too hard on the twin flowers. I'm not a big fan, to be honest. This viewing area over here is going to stay super, super simple. I'm going to end up replacing those with nettles. I just wanted you to be able to walk along and look into the exhibit, basically. The dark concrete that you see on the side is exactly the same as the other exhibits. That, I'm really not going to do anything complicated over there. I'm going to add some more trees and some donation bins and stuff like that. But by and large, it's going to stay very, very chill. There's my nettles. Love my nettles, mate. There's going to be a lot of this. There's a lot of picking stuff up and sinking it into the ground, basically. Or not sinking it into the ground. If you use varying cat, you'll see every time I place it down, some go high, some go low, some go like really close to the ground, some go like barely above. Sometimes you'll sink into other textures. It really is just about covering in stuff to make the ground look interesting and alive and varied and, you know, well, yeah, interesting more than anything else. I didn't want it to be boring. I wanted it to feel like an actual place. Every now and again, I will buy some Bengal tigers for conservation credits and then sell them off, just because I have no money. And then today we could hit play and fast forward and we would actually make some cash. And I may do that before the next video, but I want to build in the middle of the day. I don't want to have to, you know, skip forward time and stuff like that. So nettles and what's that? White sage. And there's one more. There's three main plants I was using to kind of create the ground texture. It's nettles, white sage, and whatever the third one is. The third one, I know, I've been a big proponent, a big fan, we'll say, of the white sage, but I have a new favourite bush, which you'll see later on in the video. It changes my life, I'm telling you. Don't know why that's there. I'm going to have to remove that. Look at it. Why is that there? Vestislaw, what are you doing? Yeah, like I said, there's going to be a lot of this. A lot of just sticking stuff in to add texture and variation to the ground. You get to see it, hopefully, come to life. I'm already looking a lot better, I think you'll agree, just having that stuff in the ground. This stuff, diamond leaf willow bush. Now, originally, I just like the bushes. I think they look really cool. They've got this kind of look to them, which looks like they'd suit kind of sticking out of the rocks a little bit. You know, they've got these, like, thin sticks, and then they kind of erupt upwards into leaves. But what I also realized is that they make for fantastic grass. You know, if you just sink them into the ground, they look really, really good. They just suit it perfectly. I think I probably put about 1,000 of these in the exhibit by the end. I'm actually gonna, at some point, relatively soon, if I had to guess, what I'm gonna do is stick about 7 of them together and make them into a group, and then just duplicate that and use it as grass. And you can't tell that it's duplicated, you can't tell that it's the same thing over and over again, but it makes my life a lot quicker. I've had a little bit of a thought, and again, this is just me literally just diamond leaf over and over again into the ground. I've had a little bit of a thought that you could create, say, I don't know how big the grid would be, but you'd create like a square, fairly big square, so you can keep the randomization up, and you'd have your diamond leaf, your nettles, your willow stuff, and you'd sink it. There's the group, you'll see that. So we're gonna use this big grouped one over and over and over again just to really speed up how quick we do the grass. And this is where I got the idea. I'm thinking you could do this, not just use the diamond leaf willow, but use lots of other stuff as well, and make like a grass brush, essentially. It'd be like a little group, and you duplicate it, and you sink it into the ground, rotate it every now and again, and you'd really quickly be able to cover an exhibit in grass textures and stuff like that and make it look really interesting. I actually think it's a really good idea, and I'm tempted to build it and put it on the workshop. I just think building this exhibit would have been about 10 times quicker if I could do something like that. Now, to an extent, you couldn't use it all the time because you do need to put stuff in logical places, and sometimes you want one type of grass and sometimes you want another. But I find just combining them all together just, I don't know, it just makes everything look much more interesting. Like I said, there's going to be a lot of this. Each one of these is 7, so that's like 100 right then. 7, 14, 21, 28, 35, 42, 49, 56. Oh god, it just goes on and on and on and on and on. I did feel a little bit bad. This area over here got a little bit neglected, like behind the trees, because I don't think it doesn't that look nice. You'll see it in more detail at the end, of course. But yeah, I think it's a good idea. I'm really tempted to do that. I'll just continue to be lazy. That rock is still bugging me. I wonder if I ever change that. I can't remember. But the rock must change. We'll talk about what we're going to do next after this bit, after the time lapse. At some point, I'm going to start putting some reeds down. When's that? Is it soon? I feel like it's soon. Is it now? Yeah, there they go. Again, with reeds, do you want to turn off a light surface? In my opinion, I think it makes it look a lot better. I ended up treating them a little bit like lily pads. I didn't really want lily pads in here, because I wanted the water to feel like it had a bit of flow to it, because it is multiple levels and there's little waterfalls. And lily pads at the end of the day are not part of this foliage set, even though they should be. You know, you can of course get lily pads in these kind of environments in North America. They probably should be part of the set. But I thought reeds sort of looked better. And in the past, I've not been a big fan of the reeds. I've really resisted the reeds in general. I'm very principled about my reeds, but I've got to say, I really like how they look in this. I think putting them in the right spots around rocks, not going over the top with them, not just doing a line of them down the side, I think it ends up looking pretty darn cool, if I do say so myself. It took bloody ages. Like, I don't mind, like, 2 hours is not particularly long for a franchise episode for me. I'd say it's about the minimum that it usually takes, but as you can see, because it's all foliage and this is a huge exhibit in a lot of ways, It did wear me down a little bit by the end. It would have been nice to be able to mix things up a little bit more, but I didn't want any part of it to feel neglected. I wanted the whole thing to, you know, be sort of the same quality in terms of foliage. There's probably some bits that aren't quite as detailed, but generally speaking, I didn't want to slack. So I really wanted to do something with the log. I wasn't sure what. I wanted, like, something growing across it. What I'd really like is some mushrooms. I really hope we get mushrooms in the game. I would bring in these little azaleas just in this bit, because again, this area kind of lacked something. It was kind of away from the rest. It was kind of out of view of the mine cart trail thing. So I just wanted to bring in something to make that area a little bit different. I do end up just sinking these in, little bits of grass or little things growing across that. Some little plants sticking on as well. Just to make the logs a little bit overgrown. A little bit of rocks in there. If in doubt, stick some rocks in. We are nearly done. I think it looks really good. Yeah, we've only got about a minute and a bit left. Swap out the twin flowers for the nettles, because nettles are the best. And what else do I do? More rocks. Yeah, we're going to bring in some of these dark rocks, the black rock, essentially, from the top. Bring down a little pile of those. And again, add some more grass, because I can't help myself. And then I really don't know what I do for the next minute. Thinking. What do I need? Oh, right, yes. So the water. There's another water one you can get where it looks like this. This is actually too high up, but you can see how the water kind of flows forward from it. You'll see it in person in a little bit, but it gives the river a little bit of flow. I'd like to have the ability to do that across the entire thing, you know, make the whole river look like it's flowing moderately rapid water, but I think that's about as far as it's going to go, unfortunately. But, yeah, a little bit of foaming at the top, sort of behind the rocks. That's where the water's hitting the gap and, you know, that's in the official term. By the way, I was going to put a little lake there, but I'm not going to. Still need to do things like the educational science and stuff like that. But like I said, that viewing area is not going to be a big deal. And I ran out of money again. Oh, and there's, okay. I'm watching screen free. Like, for 2 hours, I was waiting for my time lapse to process. So I was watching screen free in the meantime. So there you go. Right. So we are going to hop in game. I'll give you a nice, like, slower tour of the whole thing. And we'll do a little bit more work. There's definitely some things we need to do. So I'll see you in a jiffy. So here we are, welcome to Wolf Creek. I can't call it Wolf Creek. Wolf Creek is a torture porn film. We're going to call it Timberwolf Creek. There you go. Adding the timber changes the whole thing. I've kept it paused for now because we're in nice lighting and I want to, you know, just show it off a little bit. Basically, all my wolves are here. They're all actually swimming down the river at the same time. It's pretty cool. Look at them all go. They're going to head up that way. But yeah, there it is from above. You get a nice feel for it. It's, I mean, in formation and everything else, it's a fairly simple exhibit, really the focus was on making sure the foliage came together to make something sort of beautiful and natural looking. I already had the, obviously we've got the coal mine walk up here to the top left. I didn't really want to bring in anything too special into the creek itself, because I think it doesn't have to. It just has to sit next to the coal mine and kind of make sense. And I think it does. I think we can view it really well from the side. You know, walk along like this. It looks really nice. There you go. Yeah, let's hit play. So, I mean, might have to move that a little bit there. But same over here. The water kind of comes underneath the log over there. It kind of skirts through the rocks at different points, because it's been treated slightly differently. It's a little bit silly having to do that. I think having the glass barrier is definitely something we'll look at down the line, but for now I'm pretty okay with that. Alright guys, girls I should say, the vast majority of them are female. I think there's like 7 or 8 female wolves, and then there's one lad knocking around. Oh my giddy aunt. Just trying to get a nice thumbnail. But I don't think it's going to work. I'll do that later. Anyways. Yeah. I don't really know what else to say on this one. I'm just happy with it. It's done. It looks nice. It looks natural. It's pretty. It blends into the wall fairly well. I think using the lush forest on the right and the fairly dense, the opposite of dense, this much more spread out and the leafless forest on the left kind of gives it a little bit of intrigue, but also makes this area kind of make more sense. Whole thing, yeah, I really don't know what else to add. So it does need a little bit of work, mainly over here. I'm going to leave this for the next video, because we're doing, like I said, we're going to do a cleanup. We're going to do, it's going to be a long video. We're going to not time-lapse anything. We're going to go along and we're going to do tons of different stuff. I do think this is the end of this part of the park. I think I want to start going back to the left. Oh, that's what we're doing. Of course, we haven't done our exhibit animals left. I'm still considering whether we're going to do the... If we're going to do... Oh, I don't know. Are we going to do the doll sheep? I think so. I'm really enjoying Black Rock Park. And I don't necessarily want to stop quite yet. So I think this area behind here is not going to be anything. I think it's okay to have empty areas in a park. This, you know, we're never going to use the whole park anyway. So I think this area I'm just going to make into a forest, and that should blend in really well. It should make the bison exhibit look better. And also, I just want to point out, you can see how much my use of foliage has changed. This is the bison exhibit. And then we go over here, and we look at this one. And some people might think it's over the top, but I would disagree, personally. Maybe a little over the top in some places, but generally speaking, I think it looks quite nice. So just this... A vast difference in... I mean, that is a nice view right there. I'm just going to take a little cheeky screenshot of that. vast difference in the way I've used foliage. Just across. I think the grizzly bear exhibit was probably the first one where I started to mess around with it. And it's gone even further with this one. It really has. It's densely packed, to say the least. But, yeah, I don't know. I'm happy with it. So, if we turn this into a forest... Then maybe do the same behind here, so it kind of symmetrical, and then we can start building in this area here. And I think that's going to make the whole thing feel, at the moment it's very lopsided, but I think if there's forest there, there's forest there, and then we're building there, it should make the whole thing feel a little bit more like an actual park. And then we'll call that the first section, essentially. This would be all the animals we planned to include. We can then talk about bringing in the Arctic animals and stuff like that, but we'll have to see. Oh. Everything's so pretty. Right, so what are we doing in the next video then? We're doing the museum. We're doing the planetarium. It needs a name other than planetarium. Black Rock Planetarium, probably. And this also needs star systems and stuff on the side. We'll be doing that as well. Other than that, folks, feeling pretty good. Like I said, I think we're going to build a... I think it's going to be like a science, an open... science center thing. Someone did suggest actually bringing the exhibit animals into here, which I thought was actually a pretty cool idea, but I actually think this is already a good idea, and I'm quite excited to build this modern glass building over here on the left. And you'll see what has that feeling of lots of modernity, but then a kind of much more natural free-flowing area over here. I'm still not totally sure what I'm going to do here. I'm wondering if I can loop this path round the mountain and connect it onto that bit there, but that seems optimistic, and it's a long walk. But then again, if there's something on this side later on, then that's fine. I'm unsure how I feel about that at the moment. I'm actually totally unsure. I think linking that around there is not a bad idea. Is everyone okay? Is Panda? And give me my points. Vet research is done. That should be the Timberwolf, actually. Good stuff, because we need some wolf love. They need enrichment pretty badly. Let's have a little look what we can do. Timber, timber, timber. Not a thing. Well, we can add a sprinkler. That's fine. Whatever. How are we doing? Still not great? No, enrichment is a little bit on the poor side, but you know, we've still got the research on the go. I'm sure we can fix that up, no problems at all. Oh, yeah, this will show you what I mean by the water as well. You see that bit there? This bit, just kind of fades out, and then the water calms down again. It's a shame. I really wish you could hide these somehow, you know? I mean, maybe we could put that into the log itself and then sink it back a little bit, maybe? I don't know. I think there should be a way to actually just full on hide them, because it's a little bit silly, but there you go. You see the water fades, and then it calms down a little bit, and then gets over here, and then a bloop, bloop, and down there does the exact same thing. I'm considering adding more of that effect, this kind of moving water at various points, but I don't know. Water kind of chills out down here. They're having a great time though. The wolves are loving it. We could do with better enrichment, but I'll take 68 for now. Why is nutrition so low? Yeah, just because the food itself is a bit rubbish. That's okay. It's not okay. It's probably not a good thing. They don't have any shelter either. Don't know if they. Oh, maybe they do. No, they could do some shelter. I don't actually know how they've got any, I guess, from this little bit on the side and this little bits over here. Again, not something gonna. I think if we get their enrichment up, it's not going to matter. Anyways, yeah. Wolf Creek, folks. Where are some babies? Vanessa's about to pop out a kid. Is that it? Nope, but that is a new one. That's Tanner, which is a cool name. Well done, Tanner. What I could do with is maybe going back and revitalizing the... I love that lighting. Revitalizing the pronghorns and the bison. I keep getting rid of them every now and again because they keep like trying to inbreed. It's actually a really annoying system to manage, but I'd like to fix that. We also need to do loads of lights. Absolutely. This whole area is lightless. Now, what I think we might do, because I've got these lights here, which are fine. We've been using these throughout the entire park, basically. Well, this starter area, they're all the same lights, essentially. I want them on there. But I don't know if they're going to fit the feeling I'm trying to go for here in this stuff. Basically, this is a fairly distinct separate section. This is a very modern section, and then you come over here, and you get some modern touches like the glass domes, but even then inside there, it's a little bit more... A little bit more, you know, natural looking. So I think we maybe want to bring in some different lights for this bit. Cover the wood in those pathway lights and then bring something else in here. I'm not sure what. I'm thinking. Oh, right, let's have a little look. Let's do this now. Let's see what we can do. Maybe just a lamppost. It might just literally be a lamppost. Let's have a look at our options. They're actually okay. They're not a bad idea. I think it probably has to, if we're going to go the lamppost route, it probably has to, oh god. It probably does have to be a slightly more modern lamppost, just because. What about in the middle? It needs lights, it really does, but I'm just not sure what they're going to look like. What I was thinking, no, is the, where's my Arctic light? That. Now, it is a flame. Why are you not on fire? Oh, there we go. It is a flame, which is maybe not totally appropriate for the modern feeling and for a park, but I'm thinking we could build, oh, we just use... I don't know. I think that suits BlackRock in a lot of ways. I'm thinking what we might have to do is actually build a custom lamppost, essentially. Or take a modern one and bring in some slightly more traditional touches to make it more suiting the park. So you'd want one that's the same. I mean, that one could work pretty well. Let's say that sits in the middle. I'm fine with them sitting in the middle. I think that's okay. Then maybe you grab these little things over here. Just spitballing here, folks. Just spit. Oh god, no. Horrendous. What's going on? Come here. Shuffle over. That's not going to quite work, is it? It works on the middle pole. It doesn't work on the rest. It doesn't work on the base. But you could maybe put some wood over there. My point is, using the modern lamppost, but then bringing in some more natural touches. That'll be something we save again until the next video. I should make a list. I'm going to make a list. I'm going to do my list right now. So, what are we doing in the next video? What is the plan? We're going to work on the planetarium. Really, that just means... doesn't that look so much better? The new stars really brought that to life. I know people are disappointed the wolves aren't going to sleep in here. I am too a little bit, but I do think Wolf Creek is a much better use of the space, and I really like the mine and stuff like that. We need to bring in lights all over here, like on the wall and the ceiling, and some new constellations, and we need to add more benches. We need to finish the lights going around the rest of the park. We need to do the forest area here. That should be fairly quick. We need to do lights for this bit, so we need to come up with something. I also want to light this. This area is actually lit up already, but there's no power. I'm not totally sure how we're going to fix that. If I just stick that there for a minute. I think that looks really cool, the track like that. And it matches very much this area over here, which was very much the idea at the time. Yeah, that's pretty cool, right? Special slot, that's very cool. Thank you, guys. Thank you. So nice. Yes, I'm pretty okay with that lighting. I'd like to bring in some, maybe light this up a little bit and... oh, no. The doors. The doors inside the minecarts, they've lit up. I didn't realise that was going to... oh, I'm stupid. Okay. You know, maybe like a little torch hiding behind there, like little lights. I mean, this is pretty cool, though. It's like little ones that resemble the kind of lights you might use in a mine, you know? What's the closest we've got? I mean, that's... again, I'm tempted by these. What's going on here? Why are you being weird? Stop it. Oh, it's because position snap. Yeah. Or maybe... what else we got? What? I did have a look for something in the past, and I just couldn't find anything that I think... nothing screams mine, you know? It'd be a bit weird, you put it down and it goes, mine! It literally screams it, that would be odd. Actually, oddly enough, I think the Indian wall one is not a bad shout. Just because it's kind of like, it's like an oil lamp, right? So that's not a bad one. That one's a little bit too styled. This one I don't think is overly... styled in any way, you could probably get away with that. I don't know, folks. Anyway, so we need to light this area up and we need to find somewhere to put this transformer. I honestly might just sink it into the mountain and delete it whenever it breaks, which is something we've done in the past. So we need to figure out how we're going to light this area up, figure out how we're going to light the mine up. We need to do the planetarium, we need to do the plant life around here. We need to do stuff here, like this isn't going to be a big deal, I don't think, over here, but I'd like to do something. We need to do the museum. And we need to actually come back over here and finally write the story of the ghost of BlackRock. I think that's it. I think once that's done, the park is finished up till this point. Those are all the cleaning up details we need to do to make the park come alive a little bit more. Then we're going to do the exhibit animals. The more I think about it, the more I think we're not going to do the tundra animals. I'd really like to do a tundra park. That is, I know the polar bear wouldn't live with the doll sheep, but I think we can have... you know, those four in their own little mini park, and I think we can make something really cool. So I am tempted to do that instead. We need to bring some plants on there as well. Somebody write all this down for me, please. We need to bring some plants around that middle bit. But other than that, yeah, that's it. That's our list. So, there's BlackRock Park. Hope you guys have enjoyed. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for all the comments, all the suggestions. Let me know what you think about the lights. Let me know what you think about everything else I've said. But and also let me know what you think about the Timberwolf Creek at the end of the day. I'm pretty proud of it, but it is very much up to you guys as well. I'd also like to light up the glass city, essentially, somehow, but I haven't really thought about that. Anyways, next episode will be a nice long one. We may actually make it a live stream. I'm thinking about that because then I can get real-time suggestions from you folks, which is pretty cool, but we'll have to wait and see. Either way, that'll be later this week. Thank you so much for joining me. Please do hit the like button if you're enjoying this build. I really like this natural area, but I'm excited to get back to this kind of stuff as well. You know, this is where we started with Blackrock. This is much more modern stuff. Might change the name of the Rainforest Cafe, but the cafe itself is pretty cool. Okay, now I'll go. Thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way. I'll see you next time.